It's the WVU Sports Buzz with Amanda Mazey, presented by U.S. Cellular.
Welcome to the very first edition of the WVU Sports Buzz for the 2014 fall season. I'm Amanda Mazey. We've changed things up a bit this year. We are going to be on location for each and every show, and we also have a sleeker, more condensed show to bring you. So let's get started. I am here at the beautiful Dick DeLess Stadium, where there will be plenty of soccer action going on this weekend, starting first with the men's soccer team when they open up regular season play 5:30 Friday night against St. John's. And all fans who attend are urged to wear their gold.
We feed off their energy. It's a lot of fun to see all your friends and family up in the crowd, and you know, to fill Dick DeLess is something that we strive for every year. Every game we strive for that. So to have a huge crowd there and get a win for them and keep them coming back is extremely important to all of us, for sure.
You all were picked second in the MAC preseason. Coach LeBlanc said, yeah, that's great, but we would be picked first. So obviously we have a lot of work to do. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, of course. I don't think anyone wants to be in second place. We strive to be first in everything that we do. He's right. We have a lot of work to do. But to knock Akron off and to, you know, take over that number one seed this year, it's going to be really special for us.
There is a proposal out there to make men's soccer a full academic year-round sport, so in the fall and spring. That wouldn't affect you because by the time this goes into effect, you'd be graduated. But as a player, what do you think about that, playing for the full academic year?
That would be awesome. It's unfortunate that I won't be around for that. But I think that if they can pull that off, that's going to be awesome, especially for guys recovering with injuries and stuff like that. If you do get injured, it gives you an opportunity to get back and, you know, still not miss your entire season. A lot of recovery benefits from that, and also, you know, we miss a lot of class for traveling and stuff, so it's really important that we have a good gap between each game where we can, you know, go to class and recover. So that year round, I'm really jealous that I won't be around for it.
The women's volleyball team also opens up regular season play when they host the Golden Blue Players Challenge this weekend. Now the team is coming off their best record in quite a while, and they hope to carry that momentum from last season into this year, especially Friday night when they host number 9 BYU at the Coliseum at 7 p.m.
Big change from freshman year to now. Freshman season, a little rough, but we learned a lot from it. Last year was a complete 360. You know, we had a 20-win season. And this year, I think everyone's just super fired up and just ready to come, ready to go. And all the freshmen that came in are going to be a help. And our starting lineup just got stronger. So really excited.
What do you guys hope to capitalize on from the success of last year?
Last year, we kind of got our foot in the door a little bit. But, I mean, this year, we're going to taken some more names. I mean, last year we had 5 Big 12 wins. Mm-hmm. That's the right number. And I mean, there was plenty more games that we were so close. And this year, I really think we have the push to just do it. And we have the strength to beat some more big teams. So especially in preseason, you know, BYU being our first game will be a good start.
You all as a team toured around West Virginia. Tell me what you guys did and what you all got out of it.
So we went southern part of the state for the most part. We got to go to the fair, kind of signed autographs. We put some nets out in the grass and got to play around with some kids a little bit. Got to meet some people down there, and then practice at 2 different high schools actually, and got to see some of the kids and lift in their weight room, which was kind of nice to just go there, and they were very welcoming. It was awesome. We went zip lining, which was so fun. And then we got to go in the coal mines, which was really cool. You know, I mean, when you come to West Virginia, that's the first thing everyone says to you. So it's really cool to experience that. And it was fun. It was a good trip.
The 11th ranked women's soccer team will take to the pitch here at Dick DeLess Stadium to host nationally ranked Duke Friday night at 7:30. This will be the second ranked opponent the women's team has faced in a week.
Duke's a huge opponent, and you know, we take each team one at a time, but with our home opener, you know, we want to come out with a win every single time, and we don't lose on Dick DeLess. So it will be really exciting.
Y'all have just taken the Big 12 by storm. Big 12 regular season champs last year. You know, what are the expectations for this year's team? I mean, you guys have a lot of firepower coming back, lost a little bit, but you guys have to be pretty confident going into the season.
Yeah. You know, we want to win the Big 12 again. That's our main goal. And I mean, we've already won it, you know, 2 times, and being third time, 5 back-to-back championships. And you know, we have a program here, and we have a reputation. And coming into the Big 12, you know, we got a target on our backs, but we're willing to take that and, you know, make it a good year.
You're one of 4 children. You're your siblings are athletes. Your mom was a downhill skier. Talk about just having that family dynamic of athletes, and you guys can probably bounce ideas and criticisms and praises off each other.
Yeah, we are definitely a very competitive family. You know, if it's even a board game, I mean, we're yelling and screaming at each other and who wins. But, you know, coming out on the soccer field and having that motivation and that determination, and, you know, we all have a passion for a sport, and you just got to carry it through every single day. And no matter what, you know, whatever the turnout is, as long as you're having fun.
Both soccer matches and the volleyball match are part of the Dollar Days promotion. That means you can get a ticket, hot dog, Coke, and popcorn for just a dollar each. That is quite a deal. Thanks for joining us for this very first edition of the WVU Sports Buzz for the 2014 fall semester. I'll see you next week.